Good morning everyone. This video is for the students of class 12th subject economics. In this video we shall continue our chapter number 10 from macroeconomics. So the name of the chapter is government budget and the economy. Okay, and this is the lecture number 2. So in the previous lecture we have read about what do we mean by government budget, what are its objectives, okay, and then I told you the structure of the government budget. Okay, so basically the components of government budget are budget receipts and budget expenditure. Okay, budget receipts are all the receipts of money, or we can say money receipts of the government during the fiscal year. Okay, and budget expenditure means all the expenditures which are incurred by the government during that year. Okay, so in this video we shall focus on budget receipts. Okay, and it's two types, that are revenue receipts and capital receipts. So first of all we will read about budget receipts. Okay, what are budget receipts? These are the money receipts of the government. Okay, these refers to the estimated money receipts of the government from all the sources during the fiscal year. Okay, so whatever income or money the government is receiving during the fiscal year, that is budget receipts. So, budget receipts include two things, revenue receipts and capital receipts. First of all, we will read about revenue receipts. Okay, basically these refers to those receipts which neither create any liability nor cause any reduction in the assets of the government. Okay, they will neither create any liability, they will nor create any reduction in the assets of the government. Okay, they are regular and recurring in nature. Okay, so our receipt is revenue receipts if it satisfies these two essential conditions, we can say. Okay, so the first condition is that receipts do not create any corresponding liability, and second one is that these receipts do not cause any reduction in assets of the government. Okay, see how taxes, okay, which are laid by the government, these are the revenue receipts. Why? Because they do not create any liability. Okay, however, if we say that amount borrowed by the government, okay, that is not a revenue receipt. Why? Because it increases the liability of the government. Okay, now if I say receipts from the sale of share, okay, it is also not a revenue receipt. Why? Because it is reduction in the asset. Shares are reducing. If the government is getting the money in response, its shares are reducing. That means its asset is reducing. Okay, so that is also not a part of revenue receipts. The example for revenue receipts is tax. Okay, tax received. Because it neither create liability, it nor causes any reduction in assets. See, the most important example is tax receipts. What is tax? It is a compulsory payment to the government by households, firms, or other institutional units. Okay, it is a compulsory payment which is made to the government. Now see the types of taxes. On the basis of real burden of taxation, we divide taxes into types, progressive tax and regressive tax. Okay, progressive tax is a tax which is said to be progressive when the rate of tax increases with an increase in income. Okay, means tax will increase if income is increasing, so that the real burden of the tax is more on rich, less on poor. Because as the people are rich, their income will increase, they will have to pay more tax. So the burden of tax will be more on rich in comparison to poor. Okay. Next one is regressive tax. A tax is said to be regressive when it causes a greater real burden on the poor than the rich. Okay. Suppose if a person with 1 lakh as his monthly income pays 10% income tax, he still has a balance of 90,000 per month. But if a person with 5,000 as his monthly income has to pay 10% of tax, then it would be 500. Okay, that means for poor, it is a burden. But for rich, it will not affect. Okay, so basically progressive tax lays burden on rich people and regressive tax lays burden on poor people. Now, depending upon the tax base, taxes are divided into two types, value-added tax or we can say VAT and specific tax. Okay, see what is VAT? VAT is an indirect tax. It is imposed at each stage of production. Okay, it is an indirect tax because its impact lies on different persons. Okay, or we can say its liability to pay the tax and the actual burden of the tax lie on two different persons. Okay, its burden can be shifted. Means tax is supposed to be paid by someone else, but it is paid by someone else. So these are indirect tax. Specific tax is the tax which is laid on the commodity on the basis of its unit, size or weight. Now, on the basis of final burden, taxes are divided into direct tax and indirect tax. See, direct tax is the one the final burden of which is borne by the person on whom it is imposed. Okay, basically these are the taxes that are imposed on property or income of the individuals, and these taxes are paid directly by them to the government. Okay, so first feature is that they are imposed on individual and companies, and the liability to pay and the actual burden lies on the same person. Burden of the tax cannot be shifted. Whereas indirect tax is the one whose initial burden or impact is on one person, but he succeeds in shifting the burden to the another person. Okay, so basically these are imposed on goods and services, and the liability to pay the tax and the actual burden of the tax lies on different persons. Now, in this type of tax, the burden of paying tax can be shifted. So, till now we were reading about tax receipts of the government. Now, we shall read about known tax receipts. These are the receipts which arise from sources other than taxes. Okay? So, the first known tax receipt is fees. A fee is a payment to the government for the services it renders to the people. Okay, basically these refers to the charges imposed by the government to cover the cost of services provided by the government. Okay, such services are generally in public interest, and these fees are paid by those who receive such services. Okay, it is also a compulsory contribution like tax. Okay, the examples of fees are land registration fee, passport fee, or we can say court fees, okay, import fees. These are the example of fees. The next one is fines. Fines are those payments which are made by the law breakers to the government. Okay, these are the payments which are made by the people who break the laws. Okay, or we can say penalties also. They refers to those payments which are imposed on law breakers. For example, fine for jumping red light. Okay, penalty for non payment of tax. These are the fines. The next one is escheat. It refers to that income of the state or government which arises out of the property left by the people without a legal hire. Okay, so basically it refers to the claim of the government on a property of a person who dies without leaving behind any hire or a will. Okay, now that property does not owns to anyone, so that property goes under the claim of government, and such income is treated as known tax revenue income of the government. Okay, next one is special assessment. It is that payment which is made by the owners of those properties whose value has appreciated due to developmental activities of the government. Okay, so basically these payments are made by the owners of properties, such properties whose value has raised due to development activities. See, for example, if value of a property near a metro station has increased, okay, then a part of developmental expenditure is recovered from the owners of such property in the form of special assessment. Okay, so these work as receipts, known tax receipts of the government. Next one is income from public enterprises. Several enterprises are owned by the government. Okay, there are many enterprises which are owned by the government, like Indian Railways. Okay, so whatever income or profits of these enterprises are, these are the sources of revenue for the government. Next one is grants and donations. See, it is very common in our country that if there is any natural calamity, then people or some institutions, they donate money to the government that act as a receipt to the government. Okay, these are not fixed sources of revenue. These are generally received only during the natural crisis. Okay, so it is very common for the people to offer donations and grants to the government when there are natural calamities like earthquake, floods and famines. Next one is income from sale of spectrum 2G and 3G. So whatever income the government receive or whatever money the government receive from the sale of spectrum 2G and 3G, that comes under known tax revenue. Okay. Now the next one is capital receipts. These are those receipts, okay, which either create a liability or cause a reduction in the assets of the government. Okay. These receipts either create liability for the government, or these receipts either cause a reduction in the assets of the government. Okay, like borrowings. Okay, these are capital receipts, borrowings or receipts from the sale of shares. Okay, these are the capital receipts, because either they create a liability for the government or they cause a reduction in their assets. The first one is recovery of loans. See, the central government offers loans to the state governments to cope with the financial crisis. Okay, and when these loans are recovered, okay, means when these loans are repaid by the state government to the central government, that causes reduction in assets. Okay, that means assets of the government are reduced. So accordingly, these are classified as capital receipts because there is reduction in the assets of the government. Next one is borrowings and other liabilities. While lending creates assets, borrowing creates liability. Okay, accordingly, borrowings are to be treated as capital receipts, because we know that there are two features of capital receipts, that they either create liability or they cause reduction in assets. So as borrowing creates liabilities, these are treated as capital receipts. It may be noted that government borrows money from general public, okay, which are also known as market borrowings. Government also borrows from RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India, and it also borrows from rest of the world. Okay, so these are the borrowings. And these are the funds raised by government to meet the excess expenditure in the economy. Okay. And these are the capital receipts, as they create liability for the government. Next one is other receipts. Okay. These includes items like disinvestment. Okay. It is the opposite of investment. Disinvestment occurs when the government sells off its shares of public sector. Okay. So what happens? Disinvestment refers to the act of selling a part of whole of share selectively of public sector, okay, undertakings held by the government. So they are termed as capital receipts, as they reduce the assets of the government. Okay, it involves transfer of ownership of public sector enterprises to private entrepreneurs, leading to privatizations. Okay, now what happens? Sometimes, due to some economic conditions, government sell off its shares of public sector to the private individuals, and the public sector enterprises are converted into private sector enterprises. okay, which lead to privatization. So money received through disinvestment is treated as capital receipts because it causes reduction in assets of the government. Okay, so when the government receives money from selling its shares of public enterprises, the money received is treated as capital receipts because the asset of the government is reduced. So that was all about budget receipts. Now your homework is you have to read the related topics from the book and you have to solve the related question answers also. Okay.